Hello, YouTube. I want to show you an old pistol that I inherited a few years back. It's a 32 caliber. It shoots a 32 Smith & Wesson long, and it shoots 32 short. And it's a Rossi with a 2¼-inch barrel. I think it's around 50 years old. It actually shoots really well. I went out and shot it a couple of times a year ago, and it surprised me the accuracy in single action. This is a double action, but the trigger pull is, I don't know, man, it is way up there, probably 10 pounds, close to 10. But on the single action, it's got just a hair trigger, man, so it's real accurate on single action. And at long, pretty long range too, like 50 yards. The reason I'm keeping this, well, I inherited it from one. But this gun is made in my home state. It's made in Alexandria, Virginia, and they don't manufacture weapons anymore in Virginia. So I thought that was unusual because it's rare for me to get a gun made in my own state, because my state, they don't manufacture guns for some reason. But let me show you the difference between a long and a short round. All right, I'm gonna put it on this box so we can see it better. All right, there you go. All right, the long is an 88 grain bullet. I looked up the ballistics. It shoots around 760 feet per second, which is kind of slow. And I'm not sure on the short. I couldn't find anything on it, but I'm pretty sure it's close to that, maybe a little less. But I just thought it was, it's in pretty good shape. It's not worth a whole lot as far as money value goes, but I like it. It's old and it's getting older, and my son, and it belongs to my son, really, so he can keep it for another 50 years or something, or longer. But anyway, it's got a nice handle on it. I don't know if you can see it. It's checkered really well, and it's got a good grip to it. So it's really a good shooting gun. It's not a precision made gun, you can tell that, but it's got some rough metal work inside here where you can't see, but on the outside it's pretty smooth. Let me just give you some comparison of the size of these two bullets compared to a 357 Magnum round. I don't have a 38 for some reason. All right, well, there you go. You got 357 Magnum, 32 long, and 32 short. There you go. That's the difference. That gives you a little bit of scale to see the difference between the sizes. All right, well, thanks for watching, YouTube.